So I will speak about the early urbanization of Northern Rus, including Volga Aka region, and it is usually presented as the formation of the trading centers, which emerged in the 9th, 10th centuries on the river routes from the Baltic to the east in connection with the Cufic silver circulation, and later developed in the centers of control over the trade networks. This vision of the early urban centers of Rus was strongly inspired by the studies of the emporia in northwestern Europe. One of the central issues in this concept is the idea of drastic contrasts between the rural sites and the early towns, both in their economical background and cultural shape. Some of these sites believed to be proto-urban trading centers or early centers of power integrated in the international network, like Timirova and Sarska, which are well known in European historiography, and they are marked on many maps presenting Viking activities in Europe. During a long time since 1970s, these sites were regarded as a part of special infrastructure which accumulated privileged social groups and was multicultural and multi-ethnic. An important issue of this concept was the idea that trading centers on the river routes were not integrated in the local settlement structures and developed quite separately, manifesting their special position and special identity. Field investigations of the two recent decades that are the basic issues of the concept which was established in the 1970s. And now time has come to check this concept on the materials of the Upper Volga with the new data from the rescue excavations of the central towns of the Volga Aka basin, from with the material of the systematic surveys which were conducted in the region. And I will speak about the Suzdal region. It is the core area of northeastern Rus, lying between Volga and Aka, the territory which played a special position was in the development of political structures in the 11th and 12th century, and which Suzdal was a town which was the center in the early 12th century, and the name Suzdalians was regarded as the common name for the settlers of this of the whole northeastern territory until the end of the 13th century. So, among the most about three the landscapes of Suzdal are very similar to the landscapes of southern Sweden and Denmark, with they are totally cleaned of forest. Forests are missing, they were cut, and it is very good for field walking, and about 350 Viking Age and medieval dwelling sites were surveyed there during the 15 recent years, and about 100 of them contain deposits of the 10th and 11th century. So the main elements of this complicated settlement system in the 10th, 11th century were special settlements which can be defined as large unfortified settlements, extensive sites with the area from 4 to 15 hectares, which produce evidence of trade, craft production and agrarian activities, prosperity and high social status of a number of settlers. 10 settlements can be included in these groups. A group and six more, are not certain. Six more cases are not certain because the incomplete character of the artifacts, of the artifact collections. But also it's the they have questionable position. Collections from the sites demonstrate multicultural character of the culture and consumption. They demonstrate presence of prestige objects, presence of objects of Scandinavian provenance, though not so many of them. Of course, there are very impressive indications of trade, coin finds, keys, locks. So one of the slides show the density of finds, and a lot of metalwork, a lot of metal ornaments. One of the most important categories, and all these sites, settlements were it existed in the 10th and up to the end of the 11th century. Most of them were not abandoned in a later period, so they continued their existence in the 12th and 13th centuries as well. But the character of the economy and lifestyle is changing. So we detect the decrease of the settled areas and less indications of circulation of trade goods and manifestation of wealth and prestige consumption. Among the most important categories of fine material which reveal trade connections and economic wealth of large unfortified settlements are coins of Islamic, West European and Byzantine provenance, weights and details of scales. More than 100 coins finds were registered at the sites of Suzdal Opolie since the Second World War time, and metal finds from metal detecting, which are not in the museums and are not registered in a legal, so to say, way, they are not included in this calculation. So Cufic coins dominate in this collection. There are about 70 Cufic coins. And most of the finds are connected with the large unfortified sites. Cufic coins are missing in the Suzdal town, and only four West European coins are recorded in the finds in the collections of the Suzdal town. Weights are another important category which is presented in the collection, about 35 weights all in all, and again they are connected mainly with the large unfortified settlements, and collection from Suzdal is much smaller. Of special importance are the Byzantine finds, which are very rare in the collections. Some of them are in the Viking Age collections from Rus and Scandinavia, and collection from the sites of the Suzdal Opolie is rather rich. So an important issue is the problem of the goods which could have been exported from Suzdal to gain silver. The significance of furs in the Viking Age trade conducted in Rus is now proved not only by the written sources but also by the various archaeological remains, including collections from the site of Northern Rus, which are well studied and well documented. They indicate domination of beaver, squirrel, and marten bills. So, but the situation on the large unfortified sites of Suzdal region is different, though it's rather difficult to get collections with precise dating, because plowed soil is very strongly destroyed by plowing. Still, we have five collections with reliable dates, and three of them present very limited proportion of the hunting game. And fur animal bones are presented only in the two collections, but one of them is from the earliest site, which was settled in the 9th century and which refers mainly to the 9th century, and the other one is from the small site, which was located on the forest zone, not on the, this cleaned territory, though in the center of Suzdal land. So, the explanation could be that, well, these settlers of these large settlements were not involved in trapping themselves, but, well, furs were near, and it is very probable that they, these people were engaged in this trade as intermediator, as the just traders which were getting furs from the trappers but not trapping themselves, this, and they were in a more profitable position. Fragments of weapons are very rare on the sites of North-Eastern Rus. One of the few exceptions and one of the few new finds is the fragment of metalwork with anthropomorphic mask from Shekshova dwelling site, one of the largest sites of Suzdal Opolie, which was attributed as a scabbard shape. 10 scabbard shapes of this type are recorded, and of course the metalwork is following the well-known Scandinavian style, but none of this type scabbards were recorded in Scandinavia. We have finds in Rus, in Gnozdova, in Middle Dnieper. We have finds in Crimea, in Chersonesus, in Germany, in Poland, and on the two sides of Bulgaria. Context of the sites gives poor opportunities to for precise dating, but we all the researchers agree that they date to the 10th century. It is believed that they were produced in Rus by craftsmen who were acquainted with the Scandinavian artistic tradition and probably had Scandinavian origin. Scabbard shape from Shekshova is not the only find indicating the presence of military elite on the large and fortified settlements, but probably the most, it is the most impressive and unexpected find, as most of the other finds come from the sites which are known as the centers of power or places of very well-known military activities of the 10th century. Introduction of Christianity in the north is usually regarded as the process which was inspired in the town and developed in the proto-urban centers and towns. But distribution of the early cross pendants and reliquary crosses in Suzdal indicate that most of the finds are connected with the large unfortified sites, and Suzdal presents only two objects of the early types. So Suzdal is first mentioned in 224, and in 1110 the first stone cathedral was built. It was the first stone cathedral in northeastern Rus, and large scale excavation in Suzdal and rescue excavations of the recent decades prove that it was an important place in the 11th century. Still, we have no indications of Suzdal position as the central place in the 10th century. There are no extraordinary finds and no indication of its monopolizing power relations and craft production in the 10th century, and even the, in the 11th century, its Kremlin occupied the area of 14 hectares, which is equivalent to the area of the large unfortified sites. So, to conclude, large unfortified sites of Suzdal land have much in common with the sites of different regions of Rus, which were earlier attributed as proto-urban centers or trading centers on the river routes. But there are also differences. This settlement can hardly be regarded as the sites with central functions, as they are all concentrated on a small area and thus they couldn't be the centers of control, that there was nothing to control. The second important issue is that the large unfortified settlements couldn't have been used for the control of the river routes, because they are located on the watersheds on the small rivers. The rise of the large unfortified settlement in Suzdal in the 10th century probably is connected with the formation of the social complexity and power relations in the Upper Volga, which during a certain period developed without concentration of power and wealth in one single center, through the formation of considerable wide settlement network involved in trade and administration. The absence of a single early urban site which monopolized trade and power control over the region on the early stages doesn't mean the absence of social hierarchy and political organization. Probably archaeology in this case reveals a special pattern of social complexity which was not unique in Eastern Europe in the Viking Age and earlier times. Thank you for the attention.